Works. Okay, I'm the first one, even though I was written up as the second one. Brian, you tricked me. I submitted this talk because after talking a little bit with Brian and the guys, we've been using Prometheus for quite a while, and we have quite a few interesting use cases for it. And it would be in a style of a story, and it will be short, so you come and ask me questions after that. So here we go. My name is Gil. I'm part of the visibility team in Outbrain. We are the team who's responsible for creating the common language between all of the engineering team, business units, and everyone who wants to understand what's going on. This is us, and I'll be talking mainly on behalf of my team and stealing a lot of the credit. So I put their name down. So a little bit about Outbrain. It's the largest content discovery platform, bring personalized, relevant, online, mobile, device, content. Bottom line, if you ever went to CNN, Fox News, or any of the major content sites, or not major, we have around 100,000 sites that we're on. You read an article, at the bottom you'll get a recommendation. This is what we think you should be reading next. That's us. We are not branded usually, so people do not know it's us, but I'm almost sure that you have our cookies somewhere on your laptop. Just some few numbers, 550-something million monthly unique visitors, 250 billion personalized content recommendations every month, and 60% of the U.S. online population use Outbrain. Again, our cookies everywhere. A few notes on how we do alerting and monitoring in Outbrain. We are using it for, it's an important concept that we've been chasing for a while in Outbrain, so there are a few concepts and ideas that you want to follow. Everything gets an owner. It sounds easy, but it's not. When you have a 250 engineering group, hundreds of services in-house, and another 100 of third-party, all sorts, everything is available via self-serve tools. If it's automating code, alerting, graphing, my team provide the infrastructure for it. There is no need for anyone from the platform group to add an alert, instrument a code, or do anything related to alerting. Each team has its own call rotation, is responsible for every aspect of its service. There is no question who is responsible for VAR being filled up in the middle of the night. If your code is running there, you're responsible for it. So these are kind of the guidelines that we're using. And of course, automate everything. There is no human intervention anywhere in the path, and we can't do without it. If you're doing it manually, we make mistakes. Current status where we started and what we have in parallel, standard CollectD infrastructure for OS level metrics. All of the code is instrumented with CodeAHL and a few other trickeries that we use in our code. 4 data centers, thousands of servers, and God knows how many checks. 4 Nagios agent, 1 master, homegrown check graphite script and all the automation around it, and Grafana. 2 graphite clusters ingesting around 18 million metrics a minute, which is an old story by itself. If you want to know how to do it, come to me after that. It's too long. A nice definition of Prometheus that while we were investigating Benjamin Staffin from Fitbit wrote in one of his summaries, Prometheus is a monitoring and alerting system for distributed system and infrastructure. It is not. The important part is that it's not a long-time archive system, a business intelligent reporting, or a data mining backend. Important stuff when you explain it to your users. Features that we like, simplicity, only you need one go in a configuration. Powerful query language, which is one of the most important stuff for us. Many native service discoveries, and it keeps us warm at night, you know, because it's dark and full of terrors out there. 3 stories as an example. The first one will be Cumulus, despite what Brian said that no one's using Prometheus for networking. We roll out a new, complete new data center based on Cumulus, which is a networking infrastructure, and it's solely monitored by the plain vanilla node exporter that Prometheus provides, with addition to a few custom scripts that we added, just to show off a few dashboards that the team themselves created. It's not as easy as you think monitoring a node that has 96 Ethernet ports. Another picture, and Nagios monitoring. We also monitor Nagios through that because we still have it. We basically wrote an exporter who reads the Nagios API and displays it. That was actually a big feature. And recently we bought another company called Revy, and they live in the cloud, where the majority of Outbrain services do not live in the cloud. It took us a week, to implement all of their services through monitoring. And most of the time we were wasting on automation because they had nothing. And sample config, EC2 integration, everything went smoothly. A few things before I go. Don't start without automation. Make sure you have enough bandwidth to teach and explain. Run things in parallel so you have a reference and can compare. And join relevant forums. Usually most of the questions have already been asked, of course, beside your personal version of it. Want to join the team? This is the email, just sent an email. Want to ask any question about it? Come to me, I'm here, walking around. Thank you.